here's an example of a problem that we built a few years back where we used a backlog problem in this combination. We're always developing many different types, so we decided to make a change. If you notice the backlog problem breaks, we try to make an assembly. Because if you're going to use this style, all these three pieces have to fit intimately together in order to make them work properly. And one of our most common questions is how do you style the three pieces for your columns? How do you flex them? How do you keep them straight? How do you put them in? How do you glue it? How do you weld it? Now, please understand our philosophy of designing and manufacturing assemblies. Whenever you have a complete assembly, there's three parts. You always have a platform, you always have a column, and you always have a base. Now, can you mix that up and add out a base? Well, yes, you can. I think you lose the same thing in the same. This particular column assembly that we put together uses our modular system. And what I'm going to show you is how easy it is to take a space, an area, and create completely unique and different looks without having to change anything. The first thing is, obviously, you need to take apart the old column pattern and base assemblies. Now, this particular area appears by color canvas. This is the area that must be provided in designing the canvas. And most color builders make the face frame so long that they leave no room to put the color. They make the detail on that, which is a good thing. These face frames, there's one of two ways you can do it. What we do is we keep the cabinet back for maximum width. And I make my face frames wider to the inside of 2, 3, or 4 inches, depending on how large it is and how small the room is put in. This way, you don't have to flatter me to go ahead and apply one of the design assemblies at any time. Now, here's the beauty of the modular system. The first thing that you're going to want to do is you want to install your base. In this particular assembly, you've got three choices. If you look throughout the pattern, the Pearlworks makes many different pieces and assemblies to give you many different choices and combinations. That way, not everybody has the exact same look. In this particular column assembly, you've got three distinct different choices throughout the base. Very important, once the base design has been selected, none of our bases have a hollow back. The reason why we designed this with a hollow back is I wanted you to be using that box. We always use a new box. Typically, we use a piece of plywood, or just a scrap piece of plywood that you can sell and then you can use with a couple of wood chips. This mounting block not only provides an assembly location for the base, it also provides an excellent place for the wood screw that's going to attach to the base roof to screw into. Again, when you're using this, don't use MDF, as you all know, working on MDF is only going to be able to use the wood screw. Once you've got your mounting block, on the canvas area, it always takes some wood glue. Now, the reason why I like to use wood glue and not just a bunch of screws is if I ever have to replace it, it's always easier for me to pop it off with a little bit of wood glue and of course the two screws, which is the mechanical connection. Now, Pearlworks makes a specific glue that's designed for resin. Resin products are not porous. Most wood glues are designed to be used on porous products, such as wood. And the glue that we produce is actually the glue that's really, really made of resin. Now, the type of bond that I'm looking for is once you've got the glue bedded on the back side of the base, go ahead and drill your pilot hole. Now this pilot hole is pretty important for one of two reasons. You always want to drill the hole big enough so that the screw can actually go through without having to create a lot of Once the base is securely installed, it's time to put the top design to work use. Again, let's go back to the modular system. In this particular column assembly, we want two capitals to put them. Once you put the design that you like, let's look at this slab. You'll notice on the column, there's a recess. If you notice on the capital, there's a protrusion on the bottom. Those two particular pieces were specifically designed to fit together to a perfect and precise fit every time. This actually is something that we designed into the base. After the base, we'll be using the microblock system on the station. And again, the exact same reasons why we did it on the base. And always remember, we'll be on the back of the capital. Once the capital is in place, again, we're going to be drilling our collar bone. We're going to attach it with the square drive turbo screw. Let's just put it in the snug. We don't want to cut it down too much. We don't want to do any splitting. In fact, those of you who think you need another attachment point on the capital, because in a lot of cases, you may not have anything above the capital. In this particular case, we have a tip box that we would get up against. This top capital will be sitting open with nothing on top of it, you can actually apply another screw in two different areas. You can either put it in beside, as I'm doing here, beside the screw, or you can actually put it on the very top, drilling down into the wood block behind the screw. Now that the capital and base are installed, it's time to put the wood block in for the car. Now, if you'll notice, how this particular wood car is a piece of scrap here. I use a two by four, I put some plywood, but always I use a woodwork instead of a wood. Once your wood mounting block is installed, now it's time to cut the corners and measure them to the correct size that you want. Now, here's one little trick that I like to emphasize. These particular corners always come a little bit long because they're adjustable to the height. If you look at the different column assemblies, we have anywhere between 15 up to 30 centimeters of adjustment in height, which makes these columns very, very, very versatile. Now, the first thing that I do is I always put the column, attach the top to the bottom of the capital, and bend it into place, and then measure to the bottom of the base. I always leave it a little, make it a little bit long, and I'll go ahead and trim. Now, this is critical, guys, because if you cut these things short, it's very difficult to cut a quarter inch block. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to cut it in a slice and piece it in and then cut it in the seam. So, again, cut these a little bit long, fill them in, and then slow them down into a good perfect shape. Now, as with the capital and base, make sure you apply the pearl glue to the backside. Remember, we're going to be having a chemical bond along with the chemical bond. Now, if you look at this, you'll see how I put in the top of the capital and the top of the column to the bottom of the capital. And because the column is flexible, I can actually bend it and slide it into place. Now, what's great about the mounting block, it serves two purposes. It's one, it will keep the column nice and straight, and it will bend it like this. If you want to get the column installed, cut the length, everything fits beautifully. One of the best marker colors that I found on the market is this lime green driven wood direct welder. It's a 22 gauge marker color. You can get them in different size brand names, anywhere from an inch to over, I think, over 2 inches, really depending on which one you get. They weigh about $150 a piece. This is our micro pillow of choice. I'm not working on this particular one. It's proven to last a long time. And I've had a lot of dust on this factory that we've used in the last 5 years. Now, one of the key components of this column installation is you can use either the pin head screws, which you can drill, apply a little bit. And these particular columns, I personally Together, these notes are all the separate components.